In this video, we will continue our discussion of concentrator PV. You will learn about the effect of light concentration on the short circuit current density, open circuit voltage, and the fill factor of the solar cell, and therefore on the overall solar cell performance. We'll begin with the NREL best research efficiency charts that we have seen at the start of this section. The 3-5 multi-junction have the highest efficiency of all available solar cells technologies. What you may not have noticed, though, is that the efficiency of the 3-5 solar cells is even higher under concentrated light conditions. As we well know, the efficiency is equal to the power output of a solar cell divided by the power incident on the solar cell. This means that under 2 sun illumination, the power output of a 3-5 solar cell more than doubles. Let's see how that happens. With this equation, we calculate the output efficiency of a solar cell. The product of the short circuit current density, or JSC, the open circuit voltage VOC, and the fill factor gives the power output of the device. Dividing the output by the irradiance, or incident power density, gives the device efficiency. The JSC is directly related to the light concentration C, as indicated by this relation. If the solar cell is illuminated by 2 suns instead of 1, twice the amount of charge carriers is generated in the device and the JSC will double. This doesn't affect the efficiency of the solar cell, however, since the irradiance has also doubled. So we have to look at the effect of the light concentration on the open circuit voltage. This equation shows how the open circuit voltage depends on the photocurrent density and J photon and the recombination current J naught. Under concentrated light condition, both the photocurrent and the recombination current will increase. Just like the JSC, the photocurrent decreases almost proportionally with the light concentration. The increase of the recombination current is insignificant with respect to the photocurrent. The VOC will therefore show approximately a logarithmic increase with increasing light concentration. We can see this relation in this graph by Steiner and Dimrod, where the horizontal axis has a logarithmic scale. The fill factor will not change for moderate light concentration. Since the JSC increases proportionately and the VOC increases logarithmically with increasing light concentration, the efficiency of the solar cell will increase with increasing concentration. Now, in terms of the JV curve, here we see the curve of a random 3-5 solar cell under 1 sun illumination. We can now draw the JV curve of this solar cell under 2 sun illumination. The blue curve shows that the JSC will approximately double and the VOC will slightly increase. So, are there any limitations to this performance increase with light concentration? Of course there are. There are 2 main drawbacks. For the first limitation, we have to look into the different recombination mechanisms again. If we consider a high-quality 3-5 solar cell, we can ignore the Shockley-Reed-Hall recombination, which is determined by the defects in the material. We are left with radiative and Auger recombination. The recombination rates of these mechanisms are given by these equations, where beta is a material-dependent radiative recombination constant. Cn and Cp are material-dependent Auger recombination constants. In a direct bandgap material, radiative recombination is dominant and beta is much greater than the Cn and Cp values. However, as we can gather from these equations, the radiative recombination rate depends linearly on the electron and hole concentration. The Auger recombination rate has a quadratic relation with the charge carrier concentration. This means that the Auger recombination rate will increase more strongly than the radiative recombination rate with increasing charge carrier concentration. On the very high injection levels, the Auger recombination will start to play a significant role, which will lead to increased bulk recombination. As discussed in the PV1X course and at the start of this course, increased bulk recombination will lead to an increase of the cell's series resistance. Another aspect to be considered is the resistance of the contacts of the solar cell. The resistance losses will scale with the current squared times the resistance. So the resistance losses in the contact bus bars and the fingers will go up with the concentration squared as well. This implies that the contact design for solar cells used for concentrator becomes more challenging. This figure shows the effect of an increasing series resistance on the JV curve of a solar cell. The fill factor of the solar cell decreases strongly with increasing series resistance. These effects explain the shape of this curve. Here, the fill factor is plotted against the light concentration. Up to a concentration of about 50 suns, the fill factor remains insensitive to the light concentration. At some point, Auger recombination starts to play a more dominant role due to the large amount of generated carriers. This leads to increased bulk recombination and an increased series resistance. The increased series resistance causes the fill factor of this particular solar cell to decrease strongly for light concentration levels of over 100 suns. As a result, the efficiency of this solar cell has a clearly defined maximum concentration level. For light concentrations up to 100 suns, the linear increase of the JSC and logarithmic increase of the VOC with increasing light concentration cause the efficiency of the solar cell to increase. At around a concentration of 100 suns, the fill factor is no longer stable and the solar cell efficiency starts to decrease significantly. In summary, we saw that the solar cells can have a higher conversion efficiency under concentrated light conditions. We found that the JSC increases proportionally with increasing irradiance and the VOC increases logarithmically with irradiance. Therefore, under moderate light concentration conditions, the solar cell performance increases. The fill factor, however, only remains constant up to a certain point, after which it drops significantly. At that point, the solar cell efficiency also drops. As you will see in the next video, there is a second drawback to highly concentrated light conditions. In the next video, we will look at the effect of the cell temperature on its performance.